In this example, what I want to show you how to use is the new tag search feature from the blogs of Penn State so that you can build automatically an aggregated page with the content that you want. So let's say that you're teaching a class, let's call it IST 110. You've worked with all your students to get them blogs, they've come to the blogs of Penn State, they've set up their blogs, and then now they're writing on a regular basis. One of the things you might want to do is be able to bring all of that writing into one location, let's say Angel, so that you and your students can read that content on a regular basis. Now you could use an RSS reader and subscribe to all of your students, but if you have say 50, 100, 150 students, that becomes very complicated and very time consuming. So using the blog search on the blogs.psu.edu page, I can go and I can use the tag that we would have set up with the class. In this case, let's use IST 110. And so all of your students presumably are writing and they're using this tag with their posts. When I click search tags, what it's doing is it's going across the system and it's pulling back all of the posts that have been written using that tag. Returns about 25 on a page. So now what we've done essentially is we've created a custom blog that takes you, that brings really all the content to you. So if you would click just on this entry, you would go to this student's blog specifically. So we have this. Now let's place it in Angel. So all we do is we go up and grab this because this is a consistent URL for now. And let's add some content. In this case, we'll make it a link. We'll call it course blog. All of our writing. Save it. Now, when students come in, click course blog, what they see is an aggregated selection of all the blog posts from across your course inside the blogs of Penn State.